Okay, let's look at what happens when these things are actually called. So I'm going to create a timer thread, and all it's going to do is basically sleep for a second and then update a number, sleep for a second, update a number, and so on and so forth. So let's go ahead and implement an private int, and we'll call it m under. I'm sorry. I'm going to change the convention here. I'm not going to use underscores because most of the sample code doesn't use them. So I'll just call it m running, and that will start at zero. So every time this app is created, this is going to be set to zero. And I'm also inside of my onCreate method, I'm going to create a new thread and start running it. So this is going to be thread running timer is equal to new thread, and I'm going to pass it a new runnable. I'm going to hit tab to complete all that. So I need to supply a run method. So what my run method is going to do is, while not am stopped, have to define that variable. I'm going to sleep for 1,000 milliseconds and set m running plus plus. So it's going to increment the value of m running. Now I have to wrap this in try catch. So I'm going to click on that. It's around with try catch. And if I do get an error, I'm just going to return here. Okay, so I need like so. So now when I start this, oh, I misspelled stopped. Okay. So now when I start this, it's going to start a new thread. Which I have to start the thread. So I've created the thread, now I have to start it. And I need to close out that paren, so that matches that. And then I can start my thread. Oh, I have it in the wrong place. There we go. Okay, so now everything is good. And I'm going to fix the tabbing on that. All right, so now I have a thread, and I'm going to call running timer.start. And now I have to actually show what's going on with this thread. So I'm going to add a text box to my main activity layout. And I'm not going to specify a text for it. But I have to give it an ID. So this is going to be my running counter. And let's make this linear. And this linear. And we'll set the orientation to vertical. Okay, so now I have a box to show some values. So after each time it's incremented and running, we want to display the new value. And so since this is happening in a background thread, but we need to have the main UI thread actually update that text box. I'm going to do run on UI thread, and then I need a new runnable. And what it's going to do is get the text view. going to get the running counter, turn it into a text view, and then we're going to call tv.setText running colon plus m, say we want the running counter, which I called, m running. Okay, m running. Okay, so this should do it. Well, let's see if it works. I'm going to go ahead and run it. Okay, so you'll see we have this running counter, which is updating. If I hit the pause button, you see it's still updating. And then watch what happens when I hit home. So 15, 16, 18, 19, 20. And then we'll just give it a couple of seconds here while it's doing its thing. So if that background thread is still running, then the counter is going to keep going up, even though my app is not visible in any way. And if we, in fact, go back to Lifecycle and get restart, resume, you see it's up to 45 now. So even though the app is stopped and completely hidden, that thread that it started is still going on in the background, consuming resources, eating memory and CPU. 62, 63, 64. So that's not a great thing. Now, if I destroy it by backing out of it and then I restart it, now it starts from scratch. So when it gets destroyed, everything associated with it is stopped and reclaimed by the operating system. But when it gets paused or even stopped, those background threads continue to run. So it's pretty important that we actually clean up for ourselves when we want to. So what I'm going to do is, in the onStop method here, so look at the activity lifecycle again. So in the onStop method, when I go to start, I'm going to go ahead and stop that timer. And then when I get on start, I'm going to start the timer. So instead of doing it in created, I'm going to do it in on start. And then when I hit on stop, I'm going to stop it. So let's move this whole thing into on start. And then this is going to keep looping until m stopped running is true. So I'm going to also, before I do this, I'm going to set m stopped running is equal to false. And then in my on stop method, I'm just going to set m stop running equal true. So whenever onStop is called, I'm going to set m thread running is true. The loop that was created here is going to drop out. The thread will exit and go away. And then when I get the onStart, I'll create a new thread, which will start updating the counter again. So let's see how this works. Okay, so it's counting along. If I pause, it keeps counting along because I didn't do anything on pause. Doesn't do anything on resume. But now 15, 16, 17, 18, and I hit the home button. So now I'm in the stop mode, and if my code is working correctly, that thread should have exited and stop incrementing the running counter. So let's see if it actually worked. It should be right around 20, and it is. So as far as the user is concerned, he doesn't know necessarily that the thread's gone away and been recreated. He just knows that no resources were being used when it was stopped, and resources are being used now. So let's go ahead and use that, and we'll see the number freezes up. And it resumes right where it left off.